Crackdown 2, the sequel to the 2007 sleeper hit, Crackdown.
Yes.
Came out yesterday.
Really?
I liked the first Crackdown. I beat it. Yes. I upgraded my my soldier, my cop, my
agent.
My agent, thank you. Skills for kills, agent.
No problem.
Upgraded him all the way, had a great time with it, was psyched to play number two.
Yes.
And then forgot, I thought I accidentally put Crackdown 1
you did
in the 360
bit.
Tray
you
again.
You did a little
with this
bit.
One in. So tell me, what's different, what's the same, what's amazing about Crackdown 2?
They didn't fix a lot of the stuff that I think that, you know, big fans of the first mm-hmm. really wish that they would have fixed. For example, some of the climbing's kind of annoying.
Yeah.
The aiming, kind of annoying.
Yeah, so core gameplay mechanics is what you're talking
annoying.
About here. The bread and butter of the game.
Hey. They kind of fixed the driving.
Yay!
Right? Okay, but they still have orbs. They still have you be able to, like, pick a truck up or pick up a phone booth.
And there's orbs everywhere now. Like, they threw them everywhere.
So great.
if you're a collection fest freak.
Well, I play MMOs.
I mean,
I'm in it for, like, every single orb. And the little noise they make when you get near them. You're like, I can hear it.
Have you ever been like, just one more agility orb, and then you hear the orb and you're like, all right, just one more.
Yeah, no,
just
absolutely.
One more.
And there's a bunch of different types of orbs. There's like the live orb, so when you're playing online with a friend, you guys both have to stand next to it, and then you can collect that one. There's orbs that kind of run away from you, mm-hmm. Which is fun. And then, of course, there's the zombies during the night. And
yeah, okay, well, you can't just throw in, of course, there's zombies okay. during the night next to orbs.
They because know.
In the first game, there was a bunch of multicultural gangs.
Right, there were gangs.
Every ethnicity was equally offended with Crackdown 1. But now in 2, it's just one section of human beings and one section of zombies, right?
Right, so you're fighting these cell rebels, which are basically trying to fight you as the agency. Of course, we know that they're on the right side and you're the bad guy. Whatever.
Nobody cares about the plot in this game.
I have the guns. Yeah. They do not. And then at nighttime, the streets are just full of zombies, and there aren't even that many here. You get into these places, these plazas, where they're shoulder to shoulder, mm-hmm. and you look at them and you'd be like, I'm just gonna lob grenades in there, or I'm gonna drive through and just hit a drift and just take out 1,000 of them.
Yeah, and grab achievements along the way, which is great.
Good time fun.
No, absolutely, absolutely.
That is happy and good time fun party experience.
And it adds strategy to the game as well, because some missions do require you to go into like the zombie dens or lairs.
Exactly.
And if you go during the day, well, they're all hanging
out
in there because it's not nighttime. So a little bit of strategy there.
Yeah.
Here's the thing, as a single player game, I went, feels a lot like Crackdown 1, disappointingly so, because I did like the first one, but I was expecting, okay, they had all this time, they're gonna take this in interesting new ways, improve on the core mechanics. Yeah, I felt a little let down.
I think that's a kind of a common feeling.
Right.
I think a lot of people were like, you see how amazing the game could have been, mm-hmm. and it just didn't get there.
But with that said,
however,
that's the single player side of things.
That is a single player. When you are playing through the campaign with four friends, you're going to have a fantastic time.
Yeah, I think that's important to know, that we can gripe and pick out these little things, like, but you will have a metric ton of fun playing this with three of your buddies.
You pick up some cars, you pile all the oxygen tanks in an area, and they give you hundreds. I mean, they're giving you. There's a truck with, like, a ramp on the back of it, so you can set stunts up, and you drive the truck around. I mean, they give you a lot of toys to play with, and then you know, if you're that kind of gamer who thinks that's great, then you can do that. Mm-hmm. If you're the kind of gamer who's going to just play this by themselves in their house, I would probably not pay $60 for this game.
Sure, give it a couple weeks and go for that.
It's going to get cheaper.
And we saw footage of the character almost flying. That's like another upgrade that you'll get as you go,
right? Yeah, so that's an upgrade of your agility skill. You actually get that sort of wingsuit. You can even upgrade your agility skill to be able to fly a helicopter.
Very cool.
Around the city to get those last orbs.
So co-op multiplayer, we know, solid, satisfying. What about the versus multiplayer?
The multiplayer, it's not going to be anyone's favorite mode of Crackdown. It's passable. Rocket Tag is a little bit better in theory than it actually kind of turns out to be in practice. The maps don't really feel suited for it.
Yeah.
You spend a lot of time trying to like channel a guy into a certain area of the map that you know he's going to be vulnerable in. I mean,
so you can
favorite.
Do it. There's strategy. It's there, but
the strategy is whoever gets the rocket launcher.
Got it.
In the other match.
So it's old school Quake strategy.
If you get the rocket launcher, the sniper rifle, you win.
All right. So with that said, single player is kind of like Crackdown 1.
Yeah.
Co-op is obviously where it's at.
Yes.
What is XPlay giving it? What's your recommendation?
XPlay is giving it a 4 out of 5. It has its flaws, but it's a good time.
Yeah.
So there you go. Yeah. What's the game supposed to be? A game is supposed to be fun.
It's supposed to be fun, and that's what it is. Crackdown 2 is in stores now, everybody.